Hi, welcome to Wellness. I am your host, Linda Lonergan, Senior Clinical Nutritionist. I am here to show you the very best your community has to offer in health, fitness, well-being, and amazing people. Today I am joined by a wonderful coach, Second Spring Coaching, the lovely Kathleen Troy. Thank you for being here, Kathleen.
Thank you so much. Very excited to be with you today.
Oh, it's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you.
You do something extremely unique, Kathleen. Can you share with that, my audience, what that is?
Yeah. Well, I've noticed I love coaching men, and I didn't know that is what would transpire when I began. And I find that not many women do. Many women are drawn to coaching women, which is phenomenal. I love them too.
Right.
But I find that men are willing to share with a woman maybe what they wouldn't with a male coach. So right. there's a need.
And what is the difference between coaching and therapy?
And that's such a good question. Everyone asks that. I am trained as a coach to partner with people in their lives. I have it that they are whole and complete. As a coach, they're stuck in some area, but they're often living a successful life. Mm-hmm. And they've just noticed that either there's an edge or an impasse, and they don't know where to turn because they're not depressed. They just don't know who to talk to about it. Mm-hmm. In hiring a therapist, they also partner, but there's a certain expertise that we go to a therapist for, to either support us in extreme bereavement, depression. They're a diagnostician. We want somebody to give us advice, dispense advice. Whereas in coaching, it's a holding the hand and saying, let's look at your life together. And maybe there's a different path that you haven't noticed. And it's right. pointing out what's behind them that they can't see.
Right. And you
and moving forward.
And just move forward.
As opposed to always talking about the past. It's
right.
The past is important.
Sure.
But where are you going?
Right.
Yes.
Right. And I know in the time that I've known you, you're extremely talented in the way you have a beautiful light about sharing and your expertise that you're ICF credentialed. Can you just tell me exactly what that means?
Well, what that means is there's a global organization that has established standards and practices. So there was a concern in the early years that, and it can still happen, anybody can really technically, legally call themselves a life coach. Right. I am so grateful that I took the challenge of being trained thoroughly mm-hmm. because mm-hmm. I was one of those people who thought I was an expert. Mm-hmm. I'd read so many motivational books and done so many retreats, so I thought I was armed and ready.
Right.
And they really support you in a life coaching program to undo all of that and access your vulnerability.
Which is wonderful.
And get back to not knowing, which is the key. Curiosity.
Yes.
Is the key.
Sure. Absolutely.
Yes.
Yes. If you're continually on a journey to learn every day and not think you know everything, mm-hmm. you can only become better. And what kind of groups, different types of men, what kind of types of men do you coach?
Right. Well, also, the thing about men, the only thing I want to say is men have a voice too, and we've at times shut them down. As women find their voice, which I support, I see that we can all rise. Mm-hmm. So some of the stories that I've seen that men are told are, why don't you be a lawyer like the rest of the family? You know, I need a father saying we're stone, 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 and stone. And maybe that final stone actually wants to be a photographer.
Right.
And they may have signed up to be an attorney and their stomach churns every day.
Right.
And they're very successful at what they do.
Right.
But they're not tapping into the absolute creativity that they're on this earth.
Right. And what
to
makes
express.
Them happy.
Yes. And so that can show up in many ways. It can be maybe there was a workaholic his whole life who was about to retire and doesn't know what they're frightened to retire because they're so relevant mm-hmm. in the life that they've created. Mm-hmm. And helping them to tap back into what their heart said back in the beginning.
Yes. Very, very interesting.
Yeah.
So what kind of tips would you give to men in general in today's world?
Oh my gosh.
As an ICF accredited
yes.
health coach.
Tips, again, it's getting curious about what that story is for them mm-hmm. in any one of their transitions. So mm-hmm. I didn't mention transition. I'm going to use a metaphor. If you were to tell a fish that they're swimming in water, they initially wouldn't believe you. Okay, we want water. Right. You're so accustomed to it.
Interesting.
So for men, I think hearing, like really stopping and listening to maybe what their partner is saying to them about, you're not fun anymore. You don't play with the kids anymore. You seem so sad. You don't talk to me. Those are clues. That person is not nagging. They really care about you.
Right.
And so it would be to ask right. them to ask another question. Why are you saying that to me? Mm-hmm. What do you see?
Mm-hmm. It's very enlightening. And listen, right?
Listen. Yes, and listen.
Is very, very important.
And listen. Yeah. And dig for more rather than just thinking, oh, she's always mad at me or he's always berating me. There's something deeper.
Yeah, and yeah. there's a point where men can also share, and I think you're very gifted in what you do.
And my advice to women would be, men pause before they answer. And sometimes we take a pause as they don't have an answer. They're gathering their thoughts, and we've scared them possibly. So for women in connecting with the men in their lives, just pause, count to 15.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
Let them answer.
That's wonderful.
They have a lot to say.
And do you meet with them different times? Do you meet them once a week, bi-weekly, once a month?
Okay, well, here's the big thing. It's not to generalize, but there is something that men have a block about. I don't have time and I don't have money.
Right.
Those are the two biggest reasons to not coach. So here's my stand. If somebody believes that they are open to hearing what coaching is all about, I will have a 6 a.m. Zoom, you know, video chat. I will be at the 9 p.m. I will find a way to speak with them to support them in exploring what's available to them.
Right. Okay. That's terrific. And also you specifically and personalized tailor mm-hmm. your coaching to each different scenario or problem.
Yes. And that's the fun of it. That's where the creativity takes place, because we do have tools and conversations that have a guideline. One thing that everybody wants to know is, well, what am I going to get? It's finding out what's missing. Here you are here. Where do you want to be a year from now? What do you see? Well, how do we set up a timeline? How do we set up strategies, rewards, consequences? There's a whole pattern or opportunity to create a whole system.
Yeah.
But it starts with a conversation.
It starts.
Yes.
Just there. Well, since I initially met you, you have this beautiful light of inspiration and motivation, and you want to be determined to be a better you every day just meeting you.
Thank you.
Just since our first time to meet coffee. And as I share with your daughter, there are people that come into your life and they just come in casually and you meet them. But then there are some very special few that when you meet them, they leave a footprint on your soul. And you're one of those people.
Thank you.
And I wanted you to share today, because there are so many coaches and therapists out there, but you really know what you're doing and you have a passion for what you're doing. And just as well as there are coaches for women, it's important for my viewers to know that there are coaches for men.
Thank you.
It's essential, especially in today's times.
Especially.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So do you have a special book?
I do. I actually, so that's like asking, there's so hard to choose, right? So I have books that have been impactful in my life with right. paradigm shifts.
Right.
But a book so there are people out there who have someone in their life where they think, I wish he'd speak to a coach. And he's thinking he's Teflon and saying, I don't need a coach. I don't need, everything's just fine the way it is. This is a book that I recommend. It's called Life's Golden Ticket. And it's a story about second chances by Brendan Burchard.
Yeah.
It's a parable. I respond to parables in storytelling. And it's this gentleman who really thinks everything's just fine.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a wonderful exploration for somebody who thinks they're just fine to maybe notice why somebody in their life is begging them to speak to somebody.
Interesting. Yes. Just saying everything's fine.
Everything's fine.
And you put it up again just for a little bit so my viewers can see it.
Life's Golden Ticket, Brenda Burchard.
And Brenda Burchard.
Yes. And he has an extraordinary story. And I think that's worth tapping into as well.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wonderful. And what about a quote that inspires you?
I do have a quote that I want to share. There is a quote that stops me in my tracks every time I read it. And I'd like to read it because I don't want to mess it up.
Okay. That's fine.
A little long.
Absolutely.
And this is an impetus for why I came to where I am. For a seed to achieve its greatest expression, it must come completely undone. The shell cracks, its insides come out, and everything changes. To someone who doesn't understand growth, it would look like complete destruction. Cynthia Ocelli gave us that. And even as I read it now, my heart stops.
Amazing.
So for me to be able to be in a career where I can support somebody in that full expression and be there for them when everything is completely undone, because creation is chaos. And chaos is uncomfortable.
It is.
And to hold that person's hand and say, we're in it together. I've got it. I've got your back.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
I always say that beyond the chaos and rhetoric, we have to see the forest through the trees. Mm-hmm. So we have about 2 minutes to sum up. I just want to know if you had anything last to share with my viewers.
Well, I do. And you just gave me Exhibit A when you spoke to me about the footprint on the soul and how you acknowledged me so deeply.
Yeah.
I could barely take it in because acknowledgement's challenging for people. And yet and we're hungry for it. Mm-hmm. And so thank you so much for what you said. And
oh, you're
it's
welcome.
Exactly what I would say to you.
I mean it.
That fateful moment when we met. And and my challenge, my call to action for viewers and people in my life is, who can you acknowledge today? And how can you turn that into a daily action, especially if you're uncomfortable? You know, there are people who will say, well, you can't acknowledge everyone. How can you contribute to everyone? Life is busy. And my question would be, well, did you acknowledge anyone today? You could start there.
That is. That's fabulous. Yeah. It really is.
Well, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
For joining today, Kathleen. It was an absolute pleasure to have you on.
I'm so grateful. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Remember, when you feel well and eat great foods, it's something you want to do for the rest of your life. Remember, eat well. Be great. Moderation is key. Thank you so much for joining us. Have a good night.